Now coming to the fifth tool in this list of quality tools, which is interrelationship diagraphs. Now, interrelationship diagraphs show the cause and effect relationship and help analyze the natural link between different aspects of a complex situation. This might look a little bit confusing. Let's understand this in simple terms. So, if you remember, earlier we talked about cause and effect diagram when we were talking about seven basic quality tools. Cause and effect diagram is also called as fishbone diagram or the Ishikawa diagram. So here you have an example of a fishbone diagram or the cause and effect diagram for poor quality. Poor quality could be because of machine, method, management or people. Let's say in machine also, the poor quality could be because of maintenance and the sub cause of that is wear and tear and lack of tools and so on. We have talked about this particular cause and effect diagram previously. So now, what do we do with this cause and effect diagram is, we look at the interrelationship between the different aspects here in the cause and effect diagram. So in that cause and effect diagram, if we connect those pieces of the fishbone diagram, then what we will come out with is the root cause or the driver or the key effect or the outcome. In interrelationship diagraphs, the point at which you see lot of arrows going inside, that will be the outcome, the key outcome. And when you see an item which has a lot of arrows which are going out, then that will be the key driver or the root cause. This will be the outcome of the interrelationship diagraphs. But then let's see, how do we make that interrelationship diagraph out of that fishbone diagram? So here I have that fishbone diagram, and on top of that you see a lot of blue lines here. Let's understand some of these and that will make things clear. So let's say here we have leadership. Leadership was part of management. So management was the cause and the sub cause of that was the leadership. Now there is a relationship between the leadership and conflicting procedures. Conflicting procedure was a different branch. That was a branch of method. But then there is a relationship between the leadership and conflicting procedures. So if you don't have a strong leadership, then you will not have a systems and procedures in place. So poor leadership causes the conflicting procedures. And because of that, you see this arrow here. Let's look at some other arrow. And this arrow also is from leadership. So from leadership, it goes to the outdated technology. So outdated technology, even though this was a part of the machine as the main branch, but the leadership causes that as well. The cause of outdated technology is poor leadership or the lack of leadership. Lack of supervision, for example, here connects with the wear and tear. So if you don't have a proper supervision, then the machines will have wear and tear and so on. That will lead to maintenance problem. That will lead to poor quality problem. So what we have done here is, we have connected some of the items in the fishbone diagram with the arrows, which basically tell that what causes what. What is the cause and what is the effect. Here the cause is the leadership, effect is the conflicting procedure. Cause is the leadership, effect is the outdated technology. Cause is the lack of supervision and the effect of that is wear and tear. So once you have done this, once you have connected all these interrelationships in the fishbone diagram, then what you can do is, you can make a cleaner version of that, which is shown here. So here if you see, I have taken only the selective part of that fishbone diagram. Here if you see, the lack of management support leading to lack of motivation, conflicting procedure, we talked about this earlier, or could be leading to no procedures, and wear and tear leading to poor quality. So here we have all those components connected together by arrows, and these arrows show the cause and effect. Cause is the place from which the arrow starts. Effect is the point at which the arrow ends. So once you have drawn this interrelationship diagraph, now what you need to look at is two areas. The area where a lot of arrows are going out and the area where a lot of arrows are coming in. The point from which lot of arrows are going out, for example here, this is the point from which a lot of arrows are going out. This will be the root cause or the driver. On the other hand, where a lot of arrows are coming in, which in this particular case is the poor quality, that will be the result or the outcome. So by looking at this, you can see that what is the root cause and what is the key outcome of this. So root cause here is the lack of management support, and the outcome of this is poor quality. So this was the fifth tool in the list, which was interrelationship diagrams.